Welcome, you're watching Head to Head. Montanina Antoshev with UATV. A year ago, on the 1st of September, the association agreement between Ukraine and the European Union came into force. So what has Ukraine achieved in this period and what still needs to be done to ensure the country's better future as a part of European community? To talk more about this, we're joined in the studio today by Ivan Uz. He is the head consultant at the National Institute for Strategic Studies. Hello and thank you for joining.
Hello.
So let's draw a little line here. It's been a year, well, it's been almost a year since Ukraine officially signed and the agreement, the association agreement, came into force. What has changed? What have we achieved?
Yeah, so actually we want to emphasize the fact that the 1st of September 2017, it was a day when full association, full into force, because we signed it at the April 2014. Mm-hmm. Immediately after that, the European Union said that partially they will do the association from their side, and not requiring that from us. So that's why step by step this association appears in more and more parts, and finally, from the 1st September 2017,
it came into force. Okay.
So actually, it was a really hard period because practically from the beginning, not all countries in Europe support this idea. I try to remember the situation with the Netherlands, mm-hmm. and the referendum where they actually say no. And the European institutions think how to solve this problem. But finally, they find this solution that the association will be with some amendment. But actually, ironically, all that the Netherlands said that should be was in this.
Already
was.
In the
package. So it was a kind of game. So as now, while talking about the results of the first year, hard to say whether we succeed or no. Why? Because the large quantity of requirements that Ukraine received according to this association agreement, and not all of them was accomplished. So actually the figures about our success in the realization of this agreement controversial, because on the one hand, our official structures, our government said about 40% realization. Mm-hmm. I try to remind that the period for 2020, it will be the end of the period, so we still have several, formally according to agreement, we have several years just to accomplish it.
Basically one.
Which
is not a long period of time.
Absolutely, especially taking into account the figures that the social society says. Because non-governmental sector, our NGOs, that actually has a mechanism of control of the association agreement, set about 15%. So we see the full.
It's drastically small.
Yeah, it's dramatically small. But nevertheless, I said about that. And they constantly give their recommendations. It's several institutions. Luba Kulinka, which is a well-known expert, I think that she's one of the best in this area. And she and her colleagues from Institute of European Research, as I remember, I'm sorry, not great title.
That's okay, so what's the result?
So, but actually, on the one hand, I couldn't say that there is no result at all. So, in some technical aspects, we prepare documentation that requires European side, but not at all.
Okay, let's talk precisely. Yeah. If we're even talking about 15%, what exactly has been done?
Several technical aspects have been made. So technical aspects, I mean that, for example, requirement for this product, so we used the European standards, no? Mm-hmm, and mm-hmm. we imply them. But as I said, not in all areas. In many areas, yes, we succeed. And formally, even
which are the areas that we succeeded in?
Some products, as far as I remember, in wood area. So actually, that's why we have problems with this law. because a lot of discussion in our television, and especially politicians who talked a lot about this ban that's from their point of view helped the Ukrainian economy, but actually it's undermined our obligations about the deal for association and in our relationship with the world in the global trade organization, World Trade Organization. Nevertheless, we made the step and I wish that we changed something.
Okay, and which are the industries that the work in which industry still leaves much to be desired?
So actually, the technical regulation for me was one of the main. On the one hand, we really succeeded a lot. On the other, we still failed to sign a key agreement. It's a very important agreement for several of our technical products to be in the European market, because when we received the deal for association, one of the part of this deal is very low trade barriers, practically in majority 97%, actually zero. In others it's minor, but one thing, it's a small trade barriers. The horse of another color, it's a technical requirement. And not all our products actually responded to this requirement. Yes, in some of them, for example, in honey, just as example, in honey every single case, that's why our honey go to European markets. That's why actually even this year we have the half of the year, even 7 months, July, January, July, we have 19% growth of our trade to the European Union, just because requirements for food industry, for some manufacturing, not all, but some, really, we have the problems that we have really enormous quantity of those requirements, and the fact that product appears in the European market, it's the best indicator, because sometimes we like to say that we do everything as they required us, but the product does not go to their market. And I always ask, guys, if you, as you said, succeed in doing that work, why our product still failed to be there? So either explain that, because formally it could be a different reason, for example, the fact that European market is not interesting for our manufacturers. Mm-hmm. It's actually so, can be explanation. But the majority of fact, I think that the problem in less success in this area, like, because, as I said, in honey, in poultry meat, we see success. The problem that quota limited it, but the fact that we use this quota, it's demonstration of the fact that actually our poultry is good enough for the European requirements, for all those standards.
Food industry is not the only industry we need to work for in the framework of the association agreement. What else?
Of course, first of all, it's different products of machinery industry. Because food industry sometimes, and some experts try to say that it's low income industry in comparison with machinery industry. But some products actually succeed, but not all. So unfortunately, in this moment, I don't hear about some of our refrigerators, for example, in the European market. So we can say that it's crazy to think about that, nevertheless, why not? So on the other hand, for example, wire for cars is that Ukraine produced, and several other plants situated mostly in the western part of our country, they produce special wire for cars and sell it to EU and sell it approximately for more than 1 billion euro per year. So it's demonstration of the fact that technically we are ready. But let's be frank, we was ready in this aspect even before the deal for association, just because majority of this plant was built with our European partners who said to us what technical requirement should be, and that helped them to be in this market.
Okay, let's imagine for a second that we managed to fulfill all the obligations that we took upon ourselves by the set time period. How is the life of every ordinary Ukrainian going to change for the better once we're done?
So, of course, I could not expect the immediate result, yes, but First of all, we should understand that the fact of this association and the fact of its probably not so fast, but implementation, it's our way to Western world. So when we globally think about the situation, so not about concrete steps, but globally, it's our real Euro-integration, because Euro-integration, it's making from Ukraine Europe, not from geographical point of you, because we're actually in Europe situated, but from the many standards, mm-hmm. economic standards, social standards, and so on, law standards, because really a lot of questions still exist to our legislation. And
well, we have reforms going on.
Yes, we have reforms, but sometimes we have such a problem. I return to technical regulation when we should imply some document from EU. We try to make the same document. Say that, they ask us this document, that's why we do. But actually, we should make clear translation and adopt this translation, but not our view. Because in our view, sometimes we manipulate with that. At least it's closer to me, this topic in case mm-hmm. of technical regulation. As for elections and so on, so really some requirements exist, and that's why the Venetian Commission, one of the most influential in the Western world, they give to us recommendation, and sometimes we are not observe them. But nevertheless, we always try to say that, okay, we do some work, so and that is glad. But globally, returning to your question, in 20, in 30 years, I think that result will be, and the Ukraine will be in EU.
Okay, what if we fail?
Of course, it will be a big problem. I don't want to use the term that we lost in civilizational choice, because really what actually work that we do now, it's our civilization choice. I don't want to say that if we failed, it's end of everything. I think that we lost some support from European institutions, but it rather lost to some politicians, not for the country.
Mm.
And for us in that situation will be the best variant if our partners, I mean European partners, directly showed us whom they think will work in this direction, I mean, in implementing this association to make it. Of course, now I'm not sure that in 2020, so in this formal year and a half, even less, we succeed in everything. Of course, will be problems, but I think that European Union could close the eyes, let's call it so, but at least they can give to us some advices and even some people, because in Ukraine we're always afraid of inviting a foreign expert, and sometimes we even have a lot of jokes about the Western experts who work in our country. But for example, in Kazakhstan, that is not formally planned to be in EU, they made interesting changes in their legislation when they invite judges for constitutional court from the United Kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
Because they said that guys with experience working in that law area could give some plus to Kazakhstan law area. And
okay.
For Ukraine, we should think about such examples.
Well, hopefully we do manage to fulfill at least the biggest number of the obligations, and
yes,
we end up in the EU, because Ukraine is a strong country with a strong will. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
That was Ivan Uz. He is the head consultant at the National Institute for Strategic Studies. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned for more.